All right, I'm gonna keep this hand. It has ultimate price and is it charmed to buy us some time? And then it actually has both of our splash colors for this Chromanticore, so I can actually play him in a reasonable hour. So if he's like burn, this guy comes down and he has to have Helix or Mortars basically right away. Which, you know, he could easily have, but it's still nice to... Ooh, that's a good way to set everything up. So I'm going to lead with this so I can have Hollow Fountain on turn two for the Izzet Charm. Got to put this on the bottom. She's not the best in this matchup, and I just need lands and early game spells. Sylvan Caryatid, still the nuts if I draw it. So I'm actually just going to play this tapped, pass the turn, take whatever burn spell he throws at me, probably Boros Charm. Oh, he didn't throw anything at me. If he just plays Chandra's Phoenix here, that's not that bad for me either. I mean, yeah, it's Phoenix. It's Bolt of Karanos. Alright, so now I have two Izzet Charms up. Which is really nice. I'm going to play this, because ultimate price. Put this on the bottom. I don't think I'll need that and the two Izzet Charms. It's not like he's playing anything big. Where's the... You gotta hashtag it. Alright, second blue for Jace. Land stays on top. Pretty much anything else goes on the bottom. Keep that. Black... Green, blue, red, white from the other one. So I can cast Chromanticore on the next turn if I want to. He's not even doing anything. Bottom. I just want to make land drops. Could cast Jace this turn. He bolted me. That's so weird. I'm just going to play Jace. I'm going to plus one it. If he gains me 5 life, it's probably worth it. And he'll get some cards out of his hand so I could rock those for turn. If I minus 2'd it there and I took the pile of 2, I was going to have to discard anyway. So this way he probably throws... War Leader's Helix on my face. So he's got 6. I definitely don't want to take any damage from this. I can go minus here, though. So he's going to put Sphinx's Revelation versus... We're going to take the Sphinx's Revelation, play our Temple Garden. It's weird that he's not, like he knows we have Izzet Charm or something, it's very strange. I could just fire this off for 2. There's not a ton of incentive to do that. He might Skullcrack in response. Let me just do that though. Yep. Kill Jace. Please kill Jace. No, he's supposed to kill Jace. Still get to draw my two cards. If he plays another spell here and we draw a land, I get to untap and Rakdos return him. Did not draw a land. I just want lands. Keep the two lands. He's going to put two lands with Rakdos return. I can just get him for four right now. I can get him for five. Oh. I can discard one card to get him to five, go to eight. It's got to be worth it. He can have Boros Charm and then peel another Boros Charm. Then I probably just discard this. Multiple Searing Blood, Shock, Chain of the Rocks, Shock. We go to our end step, we discard probably this Jace and this card. Can I play Chromanticore and protect it? I need another red, which I don't have. I can play Elspeth and almost protect it. But I think playing Chromanticore is... No, I should just play this and leave open the Is It Charm. Play two lands. What? What shield do I have? I don't understand what shield I have. Player damage placement effects. Click on the shield to prevent damage to players. Click OK to choose automatically. I didn't use this ability. That was weird. Alright, so let's lead with blue-white temple. Bottom. Blue-black temple. Top. Perfecto! Really? Really, car? Really, car? Alright, I'm gonna shut my window. Why would he take two there? Alright. Draw. Sphinx's Revelation it is. Play this tap. Pass. On his upkeep, do it with Is It Charm open? I just want to draw a card, play an extra land. This card can't be bad. Alright. His upkeep I'm gonna rev, leaving Is It Charm open. For four should be enough. Now I get to play Courser, Caryatid, suit up Courser with Chromanticore, and go to town. I need another red mana. I'm not drawn anymore. It's kind of weird. Oh, that's a nut. I'm going to play this guy. Go to 10. Plus one this. Play this card. Pass. So there's basically no way he could win. I'm going to untap Chromanticore this and have double Is It Charm back up. He keeps bottoming. He bottomed last time. Bottomed again. Not gonna Sphinx his Rev. We're just gonna suit this guy up. I only have single Is It Charm up because I have to pay a red. Maybe I should wait then. It still means. Yeah, that's probably bad. Alright, I should just plus one this. What's on top of my library? Temple Advantage? Sure, let's play this. Courser on top. Play this. Rev on his turn. Oh, I need another blue. Still leaves open. I'm gonna leave open double charm. Alright, got there. It's all about just turning the corner in this matchup, and this gets significantly easier post board, where we have all this good stuff. Not sure I want the detention sphere or not. I know I don't want these. They were good that game, but like I don't expect that to be the case. Board out at least one of those. This card's pretty awkward. Don't need these. Sin Collector. Need one more card. Probably. Turnburn. Doomblade's better than Ultimate Price. This kills Dragon, this kills Dragon. None of those kill Dragon, but I still have a couple of Supreme Verdicts in. I think this is pretty solid. I'm not sure about this many Detention Spheres. He does have Chain to the Rocks. Yeah, I didn't see, like, any creatures from him that whole game. Saw shocks. Let's take those out. Let's do this. This. What's this gonna do? I don't know. Maybe I don't want that. Maybe I want one of these and this. Probably want to counterflux. Oh, he does have, he'll have Chandra's Phoenix, so I want to keep some number of detention spheres in.